Rahman Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to next lecture. The previous lecture was about interstitial fluid. We have already learned the difference between lymph and interstitial fluid. Interstitial fluid is also called extracellular fluid and helps in the exchange of material between the blood vessels and cells. Next is atherosclerosis. These are actually the blood vessel disorders, may be called as cardiovascular disorders. When we say cardiovascular, it consists of two words: cardio, related with heart; vascular, related with blood vessels. So atherosclerosis and other terminology used is atherosclerosis as well as arteriosclerosis. Both have the same meanings. Atherosclerosis, the word atherosclerosis is derived from the Greek word athery, which means vessel. Blood vessels are the porridge. Sclerosis means hardening, becoming hard. Hardening of the arteries, when we define properly, more precisely speaking, we can say that atherosclerosis, it is actually the hardening of the arteries. If we are specifically towards the arteries, then we can say hardening of the arteries. Otherwise, we can say it is the hardening of blood vessels. Next terminology is actually atherosclerosis and atheroma. Both are the interlinked words, have the same meanings. Atherosclerosis and atheroma. Actually, atheroma leads to atherosclerosis. Atherosclerosis is a disorder, but atheroma is a plague. What is plague? We can define the plague as it is actually the lipoid material, made up of lipids actually. Lipoid material, maybe cholesterol or any kind of the triglyceride, which is deposited in the walls of the blood vessels. And especially in the innermost layer of the blood vessels, where this fluid, this material is accumulated, in the innermost layer of blood vessels, especially in the lining of endothelium, or in the middle layer where the smooth muscles are present. It is yellowish material. Fat looks like yellow. Yellowish material. And especially this cholesterol material or the lipoid material is deposited in advanced age. When we get older, we go older, this material is our blood vessels are more prone to accumulation of fatty material or the cholesterol. Now, we can define the atherosclerosis as it is the degradative or degenerative disease of arteries. Especially it occurs in arteries, walls of the arteries. Clear? We have already learned the difference between the arteries and veins. Arteries actually have narrow bore. The walls of the arteries are actually thick due to the more smooth muscles in their walls. But as compared to arteries, veins have larger diameter inside. Veins have larger bore inside. So that's why the accumulation of the material in veins does not have such degenerative effect, but has a little bit little effect also. But the major effect of the atherosclerosis is due to the deposition of material in arteries. We can define the atherosclerosis is the degenerative disease of the arteries, degenerative or degradative disease of the arteries due to atheroma formation or accumulation of lipoid material, lipid material, cholesterol, maybe something else. Maybe it may be converted into blood clot. It occur in advanced age. Now, why we can say this is the degenerative? Because in this disease, not only the structure of arteries is deteriorated, but gradually the loss of function of the blood vessels also takes place. So these plaques may be converted into thrombus actually. May be converted into thrombus. What are the thrombus? If the lipoid material is converted into blood clot, it is called thrombus. And sometime these blood clots, which are formed in the inner layer of or innermost layer of or the middle layer of blood vessels, especially arteries, when these blood clots dislodge from its position and become free floating in the blood, freely floating in the blood, they may struck in the smaller vessels like the coronary arteries in the heart. If the embolus struck in the coronary arteries in the heart, then it may lead to the heart attack. And if this embolus, this free floating blood clot struck inside the brain's vessel, any cerebral vessel, then it may lead to the stroke, paralysis. Clear? These are the complications related to the atherosclerosis. Patient may prone to heart attack if the embolus, atheroma, plaque, blood clot struck inside the blood vessels of the heart. And if that blood clot struck inside the brain's vessel, it will lead to the damage of the brain's neurons. And when the brain's neurons will damage, then the part of the body that is controlled by that specific area of the brain will be paralyzed. Clear?